Hey guys, what's going on? My name is Hamish Holder, and in today's video, I'm going to show you exactly how you can invest to grow your wealth over the very long term. I'm going to show you two different approaches depending on how interested you are in investing, whether or not you want to invest in individual businesses or you want something a little bit more passive where you just put in money every single month or every couple months and you just get a return. Whatever your kind of style that you need, I'm going to tell you exactly how you can do it in this video. And make sure you stick around to the end in this one because I'm going to show you how you can turn $10,000 into $1 million over and over again throughout your life. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you leave a like, but for now, let's jump into it. All right, so both of these methods involve using the stock market. Now, I know the stock market can seem scary, but don't worry, there's two different methods here. One for people who are very interested in learning about the stock market and individual businesses, and one for people who just want to compound their wealth over the long term, but don't really have any interest about finance and learning about individual businesses. So the first approach is for those who want to set and forget. This is for people who just want to set a certain amount of money aside every single month or every 3 months or 6 months or 12 months just to invest, and they don't want to think about the economy and the markets and individual businesses. In fact, if you don't have any interest in individual businesses and actually learning about the stock market consistently over the long term, every single week and that sort of thing, then if you invest in individual businesses, you're actually going to do quite poorly. It's actually a much better strategy for you to passively invest in something like an index fund. Basically, what an index fund is it gives you a little piece of a number of different businesses depending on which index it's tracking. For example, on the New York Stock Exchange, there's one called SPY, which tracks the top 500 public companies in the United States. So it gives you a little piece of all of the biggest 500 companies. And you might wonder, what's the benefit of this? You're gonna get a whole lot of crappy companies in there and a whole lot of good companies. But essentially, this index, over the very long term, we have 100 years of data of tracking the top 500 companies in the United States. It has performed about 8 to 12% per year, depending on what period you look at. But essentially, it gives a very, very consistently good return, and a return that you're probably not going to be able to get buying individual companies if you don't do the research. If you're Australian like myself and you want to invest in the Australian market, a good one is the Vanguard Australian Shares Index. It has the ticker symbol VAS, and it gives you a little piece of the top 300 companies in Australia. And similarly, it has given about a return of 8 to 12% per year over the long term. Make sure you stick around to the end so that you can see how you will be able to turn $10,000 into $1 million over and over again, even if you're passively investing in index funds. But let's now jump into the second approach, which is to actively invest, meaning that you're going to be going out and buying individual companies and hoping to make a return that exceeds the market average. The foundations of the strategy that I personally use are the same foundations that have been used by all of the greatest investors in the world, including Warren Buffett, Benjamin Graham, and Charlie Munger. And essentially, it has a few main components. The first component is that you need to be able to thoroughly understand the businesses that you're investing in. You need to be able to understand how these businesses make money, how they spend money, how they invest their money, and how you're going to get paid as a shareholder, whether it be paid out in dividends as a cash dividend, or whether or not they're going to be keeping that money in the business and growing the value of your shares, or usually a combination of the both. Then you need to identify in those businesses some kind of long-term competitive advantage that is intrinsic to the businesses that you're investing in, something that's going to allow them to remain competitive and remain very, very successful in that industry over the next 10 or 20 years, so the business isn't going away and that you're going to be able to make money on a business that is going to be sustainable over an extended period of time. And we don't just want to look at the business and identify some kind of quality. We first want to look at qualities. We want to see if they have a strong branding moat or whether they're the industry standard. But then essentially we want to do a quantitative analysis, which means we're looking at the fundamental numbers and the growth of those numbers over time in order to identify what kind of growth rate we can expect from a company over the next 10 years. The next step is that you need to ensure that the management team leading that company has skill and integrity. And we look at this over two dimensions. The first is how well are they investing their capital? For all the money that they're bringing in, what kind of return are they getting on their internal investments? We also want to have a look at their debt management. How effective are they at managing their debt? keeping it under control, and using it to the maximum benefit. If a management team demonstrates that they're effective in these areas, then we can be confident that over the next 10 years, they're going to be able to continue that trend and make us a lot of money. And lastly, we need a margin of safety. And essentially what this means is once we've identified some great businesses, we need to be sure that we're buying them at the right price, a price that is significantly discounted from their fair value. You can calculate fair value in a number of different ways, and I usually use a combination of a couple of different ways to be sure that my investments are sound. One of the ways that you can use is called a discounted cash flow, which is where you grow the earnings of a company into the future using estimates, and then you discount that back using whatever return you want to get on your investment. And then we know what price we need to pay so that at minimum, we're going to get our 15% return or whatever return you desire. The other way I use to value companies is similar to how people value real estate, using the cap rate, which essentially takes the net operating income of a company or the cash flows of a company and divide it by the price that you're paying for the business so that we know what minimum return we're going to get on this stock right now. And then as they increase their cash flows over the next few years, our return will continue to increase over that period. So now that we've talked about the two different ways that you can invest your money in order to grow it over the long term, now let's have a look at some real examples of what you can expect if investing $10,000 now, and as well as if you were to invest $10,000 every single year for the next 20 or 30 years. So let's start off by assuming that you're going to be passively investing. So you're going to be investing in index funds and getting about a return of 10% over the very long term. If you invest $10,000 all at once right now and you get a 10% return, which is what you will expect to get if you invest in an index fund such as SPY, then it will take you about 47 years for that money to grow into $1 million. Now, if you don't have that long to wait, but you still want to passively invest, you could invest $10,000 every single year to see how quickly you can get to $1 million. And actually, if you invest $10,000 every single year and you get a 10% return, it will take you only 23 years to hit 1 million. Now, if you want to step it up a little bit and you want to actively invest in order to make better returns, then it's going to be a lot quicker to reach that $1 million. If you can get a return of 15% per year, which is the return that I target and it's the return that I've achieved over the past couple of years, then that $10,000 will take about 31 years in order to compound into $1 million. Now, again, if you don't want to wait that long and you want to invest $10,000 every single year and you earn a return of 15%, then it's going to take you only 18 years to reach $1 million, which is insanely quick. And lastly, as just a little bit of fun, if you were to invest $10,000 every single year for 45 years, so you could imagine you're like me, 20 years old, and investing till 65, you invest $10,000 every single year and you earn a return of 15%. At the end of those 45 years, at 65 years old, your portfolio will be worth over $60 million. It's pretty insane to think, because a return of 15% is not unachievable, and it's something that is achievable by many, many people if you can stick to a strategy like Warren Buffett's. The strategy itself isn't difficult. I outlined it to you before, and it's really not that difficult to follow. The hard bit to follow is you've got to stay rational when your emotions are going to get to you. There's going to be times where no one wants anything to do with the stock market. The news is constantly telling you to get out of the stock market and that we're going to be in a recession for many, many years. Everyone's going to be saying the stock market is a terrible idea, and the rational thing to do is to buy stocks at that time. And while it's easy to sit back and say, yeah, I'll buy stocks at that time, it's actually really difficult to do. And you have to have a very good temperament, and you're able to overcome your emotions and just focus on the rational side of investing, then you will be very successful. I hope this video was valuable to you guys. I enjoyed making it and I hope you enjoyed watching it. If you did, make sure you become a subscriber and join the team. We'd love to have you. Make sure you leave a like if you enjoyed it and let me know your thoughts down in the comments section below. But for now, I'll see you in the next one, guys.